phase number one, envisioning. What is the deliverable of phase one? The vision scope is approved by the customer. Phase number two. Sorry. Planning. Planning means we finish all the planning and the customer approves the project plans. So I have the project plans approved by the customer and signed. What's the meaning of signed project plans? I know the scope, the time, the cost, the quality, everything. Then the developers develop the project, and then I have the scope complete. What's the meaning of scope complete? I have built all the specs in my solution. What's the next phase? Testing. The testers test the solution. During this phase, I'm not changing the scope. Actually, I'm not increasing the scope. I may decrease it, but I'm not increasing it. Until I have what is called RTM. Have you ever heard of RTM? Romeo, Tango, Mama? Release to manufacturing. Actually, this is called the gold code. What's the meaning of gold code? It's the final code that will go to the customer. And then I have the deployment. Actually, deployment can be two things. Deploy internally to the customer, or if you build a commercial solution and you want to sell it through the stores, this deployment means put your product on the shelves of the stores. So the deployment can be internal or external. All right, question. When we make an offer to the customer, when you make the offer to the customer, do you know the scope of your project? The answer is no. Can you tell me where here we make the offer to the customer? Here. Actually, in order to make an offer to the customer, we should be where? Here, because we know all the scope of the project here. So the mistake we do is that we make the offer at the beginning without knowing what? The scope of the project. If you tell an engineer to do this on a building, you will never get an offer. Why? It's like telling an engineer, I want to build a house, but I am not telling you how to build it, and I want you to give me how much it's going to cost. What the engineer is going to tell you? Go to hell. Yes. He's going to tell you, I cannot give you a price. I don't know the scope of the project. Right. Right, quiz answers again, all right. You know who talks to the customer now. Right. As you noticed, every phase, this is theory. Yes. Yes, yes. The previous one. Yes, all right. So the answer is six, yes. None of the above, yes. Yes, it's number six, yes. None of the above. So, as you noticed, every phase has got a major milestone. How many major milestones I have? Five. MSF says that inside every phase, I have minor milestones. If you look at the first phase, it says the first milestone is what? To organize the team. The second milestone is what? To have a draft version of what? Of the scope. Well, what this project is going to deliver. And at the end of the phase, I have what? The final. Question for you. Think about killed projects. Can you tell me in which phase the projects are killed? Most of the projects are killed. Sorry? Stabilizing? After planning? Most of the projects are killed here. Because the customer cannot agree on what? On what they want. Think of this. Let's make a new website for the marketing department. And this starts from the marketing department, then the IT department comes in, then the human resources says, all right, I want to put things there, and they cannot agree on how the site will going to be. Right, let's go. These are the deliverables of the first phase: vision scope, the structured document, and the project charter. Do you know this meaning? What's the meaning of a project charter? If you don't know it, read PM book. Project charter is a document which assigns the project manager for the project. Actually, every project manager should be very interested about this document. Why? Because the project charter gives authority to the project manager. It is internal for the company that delivers the project. The customer doesn't know about this document. Let's go to phase number two. Look at the first milestone. Technology validation complete. How you validate the technology? Right, if it's a technology you use all the time, there's no need for validation. If it's a new project, how you validate the technology? Prototype. Take the customer to another customer that uses the technology. Actually, IBM is doing this. If you ask IBM, all right, is this mainframe going to work? Can you do it? Can you show it to me? What IBM is saying? Go to a bank to see the mainframe working. This is called validation of the technology. Then it says functional specifications baseline, FSD. Do you know the FSD document? Functional specifications document. What's the meaning of the functional specification documents? What are the functional specs of the solution? Then master project plan, baseline, development, test environment, and at the end of the phase I have the project plans approved. Look at the deliverables. What, how, and when. FSD is what. Master project plan is how. And master project schedule is when. Is the time thing of it. Risk management and other plans. Actually, PM book describes how many plans. Who knows PM book very well? Is anyone here certified with PMP, Project Management Professional Certification? PMP, do you know it? It's the best certification on the planet. The best. It gives the more money, even more money than Cisco CCIE. Yes. I can show it to you. It gives the most money against every other specification. PM book describes 8 plans. Scope plan, time plan, cost plan, quality plan, staffing plan, communications, risk, and procurement. And here it says risk and other plans. Actually, here it gives you the idea of the conceptual design, logical design, physical design. Have you ever heard of the conceptual, logical, and physical? Conceptual means I want to build a house. I have the idea of the house. Nothing more, nothing less. What is the logical design? I'm designing how many floors, stairs, things like this. What is the physical design? Physical design, it means I must know the part numbers of every item that goes to the solution. So everywhere, at the beginning we start with the conceptual design, then we go to the logical, then we go to the physical. If I come back to the information technology, it means I must know the part numbers of the servers, of the routers, of the interfaces, I must have prototypes, I must have everything. Who is the role responsible for this phase? For the previous phase, actually. Who is the role responsible for this phase? Who's the role driving this phase? The program manager, yes. If we go to the next phase, who is responsible for this phase? The developers. What it says in here? Internal release 1, release 2, release 3, release 65, 85, and so on. What are the deliverables of this phase? The master plan, the frozen FSD. What's the meaning of frozen FSD? Final scope, we don't want to change it. Finalized design, build images and solution code, test specs, cases, metrics, scripts, end user training. Who designs it? The user role, manuals, and help files. Deployment processes, marketing material, whatever we need in order to deploy the solution. If we go to the next phase, which is stabilizing,